All right, thank you so much, Honorable, for making time and speaking to us today on the different platforms of the New Vision. Please kindly introduce yourself.
Bahinduka, Martin Mugara is my name, and I'm the Minister of State for Tourism, Wildlife and Antiquities.
Glad to have you, sir. Let's start with the Pearl of Africa Tourism Expo. Just how prepared is your ministry?
I think we are well prepared. Actually, we are better prepared than the previous expos. We've been at this for some good time. There've been meetings going on, and unique from the other powers, we've worked with the private sector. So we believe, and of course, there's also been a lot of publicity about Powate. That's why we've seen numbers of people who have picked interest in participation grow. We have over, I think, as of today, 214 exhibitors, and there's still a request for more space, and it's a discussion we're having. So there's been a lot of talkability. We expect more participation and therefore more B2B business between the hosted buyers and the exhibitors.
Okay. Great. So what would you say has been the impact of Powate in marketing the tourism sector across the world?
Well, first of all, even when we don't look at the Ugandan Powate only.
Yes.
Because this is something we've been doing even regionally. First of all, as the East African bloc, but every country in the region is doing something to do with the such an activity going forward, even South Africa and the rest. So we have seen the importance of having these engagements where you have serious people from serious source markets come, find you in a certain destination and have a discussion about doing business amongst the private sector in Uganda, but also the hosted buyers where they come from. But also most importantly, because when we are targeting these hosted buyers, we include journalists, we do influencers, we do TV stations, we do tour operators. And for instance, in this Powate, they will have farm trips for 5 days. So you have time to give them a feel of what the country has to offer within those 5 days. And sometimes some even choose to extend their stay to understand better what the product product Uganda is, and even engage better with the a number of business partners they would have picked or would have picked interest in doing business with going forward. So Powate is a big platform, really. And that is why some countries host expos more than 3-4 times a year, because every expo you have an avenue to market a destination. So it's a very important marketing tool going forward.
Okay, great. So like you said, the Powate is big, but as government or as a ministry, what are some of the key areas you're focusing on in this edition? What are some of the areas you want to push during this edition?
I think first of all, the main things is the actual focus on the source markets, like you said. Yes, we are almost keeping the same, but causing more effort on those particular markets, like I've said. We know where our biggest numbers are coming from, and we intend to, and the main people we are hosting are from only those areas. It's been a direct targeted to achieve only that kind of niche market that we are looking for. So in a nutshell, I think that is it. Powate is all about having people that have not been to this country, and most of the people that are participating are new entrants. They are people who have not been here before, that have been well vetted by the private sector, by us in government, to make sure that we get real value out of them. Therefore, we always believe that this is an important avenue for marketing destination Uganda. And like I told you, those 5 days, they are going to visit so many amazing products that Uganda has that are only unique to destination Uganda, that you'll not find in any other country.
Okay.
Talk about the source of the Nile, talk about the Makshon Falls, we talk about the gorillas in the Bwidimugahinga area, we talk about the Chivale area with the highest concentration of gorillas. I mean, talking about the Rwenzoris, talking about the weather, the food. The biggest asset we have here is the friendliness of the Ugandan people, the nightlife. So having someone here for 5 days just to explore Uganda is not something you achieve easily. And it shows you that these are serious people that want to do business with Uganda going forward. And we believe this will transform or increase on the number of visitations or visitors or tourists that come to this country, of course, and the advantages it brings, bringing in more foreign currency and all that.
Okay. You know, talking about the tourism sector to the GDP, and we know that there are international agencies that have rated Uganda as you know, top destinations to go to. But in terms of marketing, do you think the money that is always allocated for marketing the sector is fair enough, or you think maybe we need to increase so we can see more, you know, returns?
Mm. Of course, just like everyone really in the sector, I would definitely, without, even if I had enough, I would say I need more.
Yeah.
But of course, we also alive to the fact that there are so many competing interests in the country, and the government has mandates to fulfill all these. We have health, we have education, we have security, we have all these other avenues. So yes, but even with the little investment that we are putting, we are seeing the results grow. We are seeing the number of tourists grow. We are recovering from COVID. And we see the length of stay of tourists increasing from around 8 now to 10 days. We are seeing how much they are spending a day change from around $100 to around 150 per day. So we are seeing improvements going forward. So yes, of course, I would say yes, we should increase the...
Yeah.
But so far, we agree. And like we say, tourism is not just a one sector kind of focus drive to achieve results.
Mm.
We work across all the other sectors. If the works and transport sector is working on the roads, on the infrastructure, if the president, like for instance, he's our biggest supporter, what he has done in terms of pulling investors for us to do the different aerodromes. Airports are being expanded across the country, around 5, I think. And the Kisoro Mugahinga area is being improved in terms of infrastructure, at least as being told by Minister of Works the other day.
Okay.
When we have security interventions quickly coming, especially when we have those few challenges like we had towards the end of last year in the Rwenzori area. So it's a multi-sector. You need to have a multi-sector approach to achieve these results. So yes, we would say we want more, but still we see that there is some improvement.
Yeah.
And we hope that it will continue improving as we go forward.